What is going on, Fox fans? Now, a few of you guys messaged us about this Mototech 36-volt, 1,000-watt motorcycle and asked about the different battery options. And, you know, if you've been looking around at a few of these, you'll notice that there's a lot of these motorcycles that are kind of the style, but you'll have a 36-volt. I believe there's a 48-volt, and I'll pull it up right there so you guys can kind of see. And they're pretty much the same thing. It's just, yeah, just you know, the electronics are different. So the 36-volt, 1,000-watt, don't get me wrong, it's fast, but, I mean, hey, why not do a 48-volt if you can, right? So one of the things I was thinking was, you know what, let's check out to see if we can upgrade the battery first, see what options are available, how much is it, and even if it's worth it, right? So right now inside the inside here, it's a 10-amp-hour battery, and it's going to go, I don't know, I mean, if you're going – you don't mess around, it's going to be like 45 minutes to an hour, somewhere right in there, depending on how fast the, you know, the kid's running this thing around. You got a 1,000-watt motor, so again, about an hour. When I went out and rode it on the trails with a little kiddo and he was following me around, we got about 45 minutes, 50 minutes out of it, right? It was like maybe 8-7 miles, somewhere right in there. And it's, that's about right. I mean, you know, you got the kid on it, you're going up and down hills, and I thought, you know, we need a little bit more than that. The 10,000 amp hours just isn't enough, right? We need a little bit more. So let me show you guys where the battery pack is and everything like that so you guys can kind of, you know, get an idea. And then I'm also going to show you the battery options that I'm going to get, and hopefully when we get them in, we can see, you know, how well they stand up against the stock battery. So to get into the battery, pretty straightforward. There's just really just two bolts here and here. You kind of got to wiggle it and then pull it. And you can see, I mean, pretty straightforward where they go. It just kind of slides in up on the top there, and it opens up like this. And here's the battery. I mean, not that much to it. It's held in, of course, by this these two rubber straps that go in the back and the front. If you guys know, of course, up there is the actual controller itself. Then you got the wiring to go to the fuse, and it just goes right up to the top. So putting a new battery in here is pretty straightforward, especially if you want to use these two connectors, or take those connectors and add your own connector. Really up to you. Now, the original battery inside this unit, you guys can kind of see here. Here is the, hopefully that I'll focus in on that. The width of it is 190, 140 by 70 millimeters, right? So it's not that big. It's really the plastic case itself, which is big. I mean, this kind of protects the battery. And, you know, for the most part, I mean, nothing's going to get in here, especially if you're not going over water. I mean, you could probably put some stuff around it to protect it a little bit. Now, again, this is a 1,000-watt, 10-amp-hour battery, so you're only going to get maybe 8 miles. Somewhere right in there. And looking online, I'll pull it up here. There's a 20-amp-hour, basically 200 by 140 by 70, which, again, is only 10 millimeters bigger, so it's only going to be probably actually as big as the box itself, which isn't that bad. And it's actually going to be smaller, so it's going to be down here because it's not going to be covered by the box. As you can see, it doesn't cover, you know, the full top of it. It just kind of protects it. Mine had some of these in there to kind of make it so it doesn't bounce around. So it's actually not as big as this. It's right about here. And what I did is I made kind of these foam, or not these foam, but these cardboard cutouts to kind of get an idea of what it would look like, you know, when it's in there. So I didn't know the original size of the original battery. So now that I noticed that it was basically, again, 190 by 140 by 70, the one that I'm going to pull up on the screen here is 200 by 140 by 70 for $180. And it's the same thing, but only 10 millimeters bigger, which it'll fit perfectly in here. It might even actually fit inside the original case some if you modify it just a little bit. So that is one option, and you're going to get double the actual runtime, which I think is cool. Now, there is another one here, which was, I think this one was like $140. It was 185 by 100 by 68, so it's just slightly smaller. A lot skinnier, but this one I think uses cells comparison to the LiPo kind of cells themselves. So it's much smaller. You guys can kind of, let me see if I can kind of get those. You guys see that right there? I mean, it's much skinnier comparison to the other one, but hey, you know, you could throw this one in there. I was thinking, man, you could even like run these in parallel, you know, just strap them down and get like three times the runtime with the old one, or just get two of these bad boys, right? I mean, Oh, I think because they're like 140 or something like that. So I was thinking, man, you can just run two of those and you get a lot of runtime. But I think that getting, you know, 16, 17 miles off a pack that is the same size as the pack that's in there, oh man, is I mean, I think that's awesome. So I'm probably gonna go with the one that was here. Again, I'll pull it up on the screen. Is the 200 by 140 by 70. You know, just again, it's 180 or 190 with a charger. I'm gonna try it out and see how it goes. And I mean, it's almost a direct swap. Maybe do a little bit of soldering here. You know, take off these two leads, put on my own, you know, two new leads. It shouldn't be that difficult. And then I'll probably end up on the side here, just maybe drilling a hole here for the actual charger port, not using the charger through the thing. So I don't know. I mean, I just wanted to throw that out there. Some of you guys were asking me about, you know, the different options when it comes to the batteries. And I'm thinking, wow, for 10 more millimeters, getting double the capacity of the battery, I think that's awesome. I think that getting 15 miles out of this thing is well over enough for a kid to use. In another video, we're going to talk about some of the electronics. Some of you guys were asking me, you know, what size kits you can put in here. And I've been doing a little bit of research about the 48 volt kits that they're putting in here, as well as the 1500 watt motors on the same frame. It is everything the same. It's just different electronics. It is a little bit pricey on the ones that I've seen. So I'm going to kind of take a look and see, you know, if we can get the controller and get the get everything but the battery. The battery I'll probably end up getting on eBay since it seems like I can get them pretty cheap there. But there you go, guys. Again, those are just some of the battery options that I've seen. But for, again, 10 millimeters more in length, man, I can get double the capacity. But I understand it is $200. So, you know, it is kind of pricey, but I definitely think it is definitely a must-have upgrade, especially if you want, you know, just more life out of this thing. I mean, 20 amp hours, that's quite a bit. So let me know what you guys think in the comments, and hopefully here soon we can get, you know, an idea on upgrading the motor and all the electronics of the 48-volt kit after we do the battery. Anyways, let me know what you guys think. Thanks again, guys.